When you look at each week, I would start right here, chapter goals. So each one is done by chapter. It's going to pop up like this. It's going to show in each section what the goals are and what I hope you're going to be able to do at the end of each section. Right? So as soon as you're done with that, scroll back up here and this will take you right back up to the front. Then I would have you look at the assignments next. This is going to tell you what each section is and your assignment for each one. So in this particular one, assignment sheet each one, section 1-1, it's on page 10, problems start there. The assignment is 5 to 50 every fifth. Section 1 to 2 starts on page 25. You're going to do problems 40 to 52 all, and so on for each section all the way down. Then at the bottom, you're going to have homework checks, and we'll explain those in just a minute, and then you're going to have a test on each chapter. So those are your assignments. Again, you move around by simply clicking this. It'll take you back to the Moodle homepage. Then you'll have to scroll down to week one. You can do things a couple of different ways. You can either start out with a lecture as a video for each one, or you can do a PowerPoint. I'm going to start out showing you what the lectures are going to look like. If you were in the classroom, you would see me on the board going over this material. So I have done a video highlighting what the main skills in each unit are. So it's going to pop up just like this. Hit the play.
These are the lectures
screen like this.
Online, Columbia Gorge Community College, the Dallas, Oregon. Instructor William Hughitt. First section is section 1-1. You can look along with us here.
Right here in this corner is going to be the full screen that'll pop it up to the full screen on your computer.
You have the basic introduction here,
and this, of course, will
remind us some common terms.
So I have one of these created for each section in the book. Okay, let's go back up here. Another way you can look at the information is I also have a PowerPoint for each one of those. If you don't have Office on there, remember we talked about going up and loading a PowerPoint viewer, and I'll review that up here with my little arrow. So you can go to either one of those to download the PowerPoint viewer, and you'll be able to see these. So let's take a look at one of those. So you pop that, it's going to go on the bottom of the screen, then you'll have to upload it then. And I got a lot of things running on my computer right now, so it's taking a moment. So it's going to pop up to this. Notice each individual slide is down here. You're going to have the objectives for each section, just like in the home page there. Have additional coursework. And if you go clear down to the bottom, you're going to have homework help for each one of these. Now, if you go and you make these the full sheet, full size, you're going to see the audio sound. And if you hit that,
Number one, the digits 843. We read them just like we say them, 843.
I have put additional voiceover and homework help for each section. So these are on the end of each of the PowerPoints. You're going to have homework help for each of the sections. So I would encourage you to view both of these, the audio, YouTube, and the PowerPoint. So let's get out of here. Let's go back up to our main problem. At the end of each section, then you're going to have a homework check. So you hit this after you've done the homework and the assignment. So you should have your assignment already completed because you've already looked at the assignment and know that for section one, you're doing fifths. So when you do this, then you're going to take your quiz. You're going to say homework section chapter one, section one. This is a self-check to be used once you've completed the homework. It is timed, 5 minutes. You must have the homework completed before you're starting this. Okay, I have a time limit, so you'll do the homework instead of just simply taking the 5-problem self-check, because you really need to do all of those problems to master the skills. So once you have your homework done, you can come in here. It says quiz, hit that, and then it says fill in the answer to problem number 5. So you'll just simply type whatever it is, fill it in, and then on the bottom, you'll have submit. See if I can get it, I can't quite, but on the very bottom of the screen, it's going to say submit, it comes up and I can see it. It'll also tell you As soon as you hit submit, it's going to tell you if the answers are right or wrong. If you had the answer wrong, the correct answer is going to pop up. These are graded on if you did it. It's not your score, so it's okay to miss something. You'll get the correct answer. You can go back then and compare the answer that you got to the correct answer and hopefully learn that way. So you're going to be assessed on if you completed these. Okay. Probably if you have a whole bunch of scores that are low and needing additional help, you and I are going to be in communication. So once you have that, see if I can get back here, there we go. So you've done your homework, you've viewed the lecture, you've done the PowerPoint, you've done the homework check, you've done all of these, each section, you're ready for the test. So go ahead and hit download the test. So it's going to pop up. Okay, and then what I would like you to do, see if I can get up here to the screen, you're going to be able to do a highlight. So it says highlight the color. So go ahead and tap that, and then when you take your test, simply color it in. I'm not saying that's the correct answer, I'm just using it as an example. Same thing here, and there we go, A. All right, so those are going to be highlighted. Then you're going to go up there and you're going to save it. So save as chapter one, save it to your desktop. It's where I would put it. Okay, and then you're going to upload it. So you're going to save these. I'm not going to save the changes. Okay, and then you go down here, it says chapter test one, upload. So you're going to hit that button. It says choose a file. So you're going to go to your desktop where you saved it, and it's going to say chapter one, and you're going to hit this button and pull it up. And it'll, once you choose a file, and then it say upload this file. You can do this multiple times, because when you pull it up, you're going to see it there. And if you say, whoops, maybe I forgot to do problem 21. Okay, you can go back, do problem 21, and upload it again. Okay, you can upload it until I close the test. And the test is going to be closed on the due date, which is generally going to be a Saturday at basically midnight. After that point, you won't be able to upload the test anymore, but you can do it a couple of times if you need to. Remember to type in your name on the top of the test. As a reminder then, the test will close basically at midnight. Now, I may not stay up every Saturday night and close the test exactly at midnight, but that's when they're scheduled to be closed. Sometimes I will, sometimes I won't, maybe Sunday morning. Don't bet on that though. Try to get your work done in on time. Now, I also understand that life happens. So for homework and self-checks and doing those things, each week generally is a chapter. There are 8 chapters in our text. So each week then, let's go back and look at that here. So each week basically is a chapter. Week 1 is all for chapter 1, week 2, chapter 2, and so on. When we get down to chapter 3 and chapter 4, they're a little longer. So I'm going to give you a little bit of grace time in week 5 to kind of get caught up if you should happen to get a little bit behind. Notice though on these sections, I have section 3 and then section 3A. Anything that it with an A on it is going to mean algebra. It's going to be one of our algebra units. And we'll have a number of those throughout our textbook as they're getting you ready for Math 60, which is the next course in the math sequence. So when you see an A, that's going to be the algebra pages. When you get down to week 5, basically there's no additional coursework other than reviewing for the midterm and then taking the midterm. So there's some assignments here to review, get caught up, and then continue on in the second half of the book. Okay, it's about a chapter a week. So we only have 11 weeks together, so we're humming right on through the material here. And then when we get clear down to the end, week 10 is again a little bit of a catch-up week to a certain degree, reviewing for the final, and then week 11 is the final. So we're moving right through the material. Hopefully this helps. If you have questions, don't hesitate to email me with anything that you might need. I'll get back to you generally that day. I try to keep track of my email daily, but if not, it may be the next day. And good luck with the course. Again, have fun. I think math is fun. I enjoy it. Not everybody can say that, but hopefully you and I will both have fun teaching and learning in this course. Good luck.